It is always interesting to be a participant at film festivals where filmmakers, enthusiasts, and entrepreneurs, apart from the film screenings and networking, take time out to share experiences of their local film industries and learn something about the different film environments across the world. It was at one of those industry sessions at the just concluded Africa International Film Festival, AFRIFF, that film was discussed as a tool of diplomacy. Julian Izano, Aide Auxiliary Cinemas du Monde at CNC, who talked about the possibility of Nigeria entering into co-production with France, opened the discussion on how filmmakers can relay sensitive information without offending the sensibilities of government and the people. The panel had Charles Novia recalling how Nollywood started at a time when Nigeria was under the military government, and how some of its narratives had aided the return of democracy in Nigeria. Unfortunately, it has not been a walk in the park for filmmakers to air their critique of politics and the public service under the current democratic dispensation. While Novia also blamed the dearth of revolutionary filmmaking on the laziness of filmmakers to employ literary allusions in bringing government heresies to the fore, Obi Asika noted that, apart from the fact that government may frown at its critics, there is a lot of self-censorship going by our cultural orientation. According to him, the world seems to have run out of original story ideas, thus, many hide under the excuse of institutional censorship. If you have any story to tell, tell it, and don't be afraid, he said. Prompted by this discussion, I realized that, in actual fact, Nigerian films of today are deficient in record of satire, as we had among the earlier filmmakers. Even using film as direct confrontation to bad governance is a rarity. One can only wonder how much references would be available of revolutionary films, if the late Afrobeat founder, Fela Anikula Pokuti, was a filmmaker. In the face of harsh government policy and censorship of motion picture works, filmmakers in other clans, as I often say, have found their voice in exile. This was what many thought Ishe Abeko would do when his documentary, Fueling Poverty, was outlawed by the government of Nigeria through the National Film and Video Censors Board, NFVCB. Abeko was probably silenced by patriotic spirit. He would do nothing further like root a revolutionary film at international film festivals or go into a co-production with foreign agencies just to wash the country's dirty linen on the global stage. Well, let's just say that what works for one man may not work for another. Otherwise, Sudanese filmmaker, Hajuje Kuka, wouldn't have defeated Omar al-Bashir at the Durban International Film Festival, DIFF, in 2015. It was one of those cases of film in exile, and it earned Kuka a reward when his documentary film, Beats of the Antonov, which depicts al-Bashir, not just as the kind of leader who drops bombs on unarmed civilians, but also as a racist who divides his country along racial and ethnic lines, won the ArtWatch Africa laurel. The artiste has been winning awards for the daring film that shows the vicious treatment the citizens are facing in the hands of the country's leader.